started another week. Guide us and save us. We pray that as we go to sleep this night, may no ill dreams disturb our rest. Guide us. Be not at our bedside, but be with us right on our beds. And anoint us so that in the morning we will feel nourished and enabled to carry out your task. Through the same Jesus Christ and Lord. Amen. To this end, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with whatever we touch, do, or say this week. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the ever-blessed Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Thanks.
I have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our friends or neighbors as ourselves. For that we are truly sorry, and we humbly repent our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. May the Almighty God and merciful God grant us pardon, that you are the designer. May we realize that all we do is for your will. May we realize that all that we should do and that we will be doing will not be for our own uplift, but for the uplift of others. Lord, help us to discover our true selves, the true selves that you have instilled in us at the time you created us, at the time that we were conceived. Help us to go near you, to know who we are, so that we will not continue to imagine ourselves to be what and who we are not. But we believe that by your grace, we will be women of substance. We will be men of substance. We will be persons of substance. Because what we do, what we say, and how we interact will not be selfish. We will be candid. We will be true. We will be just. And above all, we will be loving. We will show love to one another, believing that it is that love which we will share that will make us women of substance, men of substance, and persons of substance. Because it is that love that has made Christ the supreme man of substance of all. To this end, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with whatever we touch, do, or say this week. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the ever-blessed Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all this moment, this week, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. And as I go, I will play music for the only person that I would. Let us take a moment and put all our worries behind us as we meditate on His word and confirm our doubts. May we believe by the end of this hour that all things are possible. Lord God, we thank you for calling us into the company of those who trust in Christ and seek to obey His will. May your Spirit guide and strengthen us in mission and service to your world, for we are no longer strangers, but pilgrims together on the way to your kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the light of the world. Free us from all that darkens our lives and bring us to the eternal light and joy. Through the power of Him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. All just believe, and all will be well. All will be possible. Grandma and uncle, that rheumatism, that arthritis, any pain in your body, just believe. He will touch you. It's possible. He made the lame to walk. You are not lame. Arthritis and rheumatism, it will happen. He made the blind to see. Only believe. Blind Bartimaeus. He called upon Christ. Christ said, what should I do for you? He said, let me receive my sight. And Christ said, receive your sight. He did that. He was born blind. And at the time, it was believed that the parents of Bartimaeus had sinned. So the baby was born blind because of the sins of the fathers, from the parents, and he will not see again. They never allowed Bartimaeus to enter the temple, to go into the church, because being blind from birth means you are unclean and sinful, and you will never be saved. You'll never get close to the Savior, but it became possible because he believed. I know that we will believe. We believe if we have faith, and we'll pray that God will give us faith. And when we have faith and we are in union with Him, everything will become possible. Let us pray. First, we pray for His guidance this night. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that by thee we being defended from the fear of our enemies may pass our time this night in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Light in our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ our Lord. To this end, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with what evening, this afternoon, this morning, depending on where we are at this time. Praying for ourselves, giving you thanks for those moments wherein you have kept us calm. We pray for those who are having anxious times at this moment, dear Lord. Those are quite anxious. quite scarceless. Lord, we pray that we will hear your voice saying to us, peace, be still. Amen. I join those who celebrated their birthdays this past week, together with those celebrating their birthdays today, and those who will be celebrating their birthdays during this week which we just started. Lord, in thanksgiving and in hope, we give you thanks for the things that you have in store for them. Lord, guide them that they will continue to be in health and in strength. Lord, free them from all harm and danger. Guide them and direct their paths in the ways of justice, truth, and peace. This we ask in the name of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We will pray for us to receive that peace which Christ received while he was on the cross. When they spat upon him, when they insulted him, when they placed the crown of thorns on him, he had so much peace within himself that he prayed for those who had nailed him, that he prayed for those who had insulted him. I guess they had their own social media at that time. He prayed for those who were insulting and provoking him on the social media in those days. It couldn't be WhatsApp or Facebook, they had their own social media. We've always been communicating, we've always been conversing, gossiping. He prayed for them, Father, Father, forgive them. He prayed, Father, forgive them. He went on to make a defense for them. He went on to make an excuse for them in saying, for they know not what they do. It's that reason, and that reason alone, that caused him to complete the task and to die in peace, only to rise again. I pray that we will have that peace. That whatever might be making us feel at this time as if we have been nailed on the cross, whatever is making us feel at this time as if we have been crowned with thorns, whatever might make us be feeling at this time as if people are spitting us, pray that we will have that peace within us. The same peace which Christ had for him to say, Father, forgive them. But in our daily tasks, as we set out during this week, we will give thanks to God because for some of us, it has been peaceful, and no matter what, we don't have any doubt that we're going to start the week peacefully and continue peacefully in spite of everything. We've been blessed. Let us not be content just with ourselves. Let us pray for those who don't have that peace and confidence that there is a God who will take them through as he did for others. In your anxiety, in your joy, in your laughter, especially in your anxiety this week, God is with you. Peace. Be still. Let us pray. First, I want you to pray in silence, because it was only in silence that Elijah had that small voice. We tend to be noisy most of the time, and we may not hear when he is speaking to us. silence we will believe if we have not yet believed. We will continue to believe that He is with us. And so we pray for peace, dear Lord. Not the easy peace built on complacency. We pray for real peace. The peace God's love alone can see. We pray for peace. And not the evil peace, defending unjust laws and nursing prejudice, but for the real peace of justice, truth, brotherhood, and sisterhood. God, give us peace. If you withdraw your love, there is no peace for us, nor any hope of it. With you to lead us on through death, through life, through our daily task, peace will come. To this end, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with whatever we touch, do, or say this week. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the ever-blessed Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all, today, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Next week I'll be talking about harvest, I'll be talking about enjoyment. But today, the Spirit has moved to talk to you, as I've written to myself, to talk to you who may have something that seems, and sisters across the world and across all generations who rejoice in sharing love and faithfulness. We thank you for the rich inheritance of saints into which we have entered, for the great cloud of witnesses which surround us, leaders and thinkers, people of faith and commitment, who have influenced our lives and who continue to influence our lives. We pray for those who have gone before us. We pray for those who are still with us, encouraging us to keep the faith. We give glory to you. We thank you for revealing your love to us through your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May light perpetual continue to shine upon their graves. Lord, may angels lead them into paradise. May the saints and martyrs receive them on their arrival and lead them into God's eternal kingdom and everlasting life. May the choirs of heaven receive them and grant them eternal rest. We say this through Him who came and died to save our sins, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now, I'd just like to just as we look back to learn, help us to look forward in hope. Christ, you are the Savior, Comforter, Brother, and Friend. We pray for those who lost their lives at the Greenfield Tower, and for those who continue to mourn their loss. We pray for the 39 people who lost their lives in the lorry carrying a container wherein they were being transported. Loving God, we pray for those who recently lost their lives in the fire, in the train, in Pakistan. Loving God, we remember those who are dying at this time. Be thou their comfort. As we go to bed this night, lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord. And by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. To this end, Christ, the Good Shepherd, enfold you with love, fill you with peace, and lead you in hope this day and all your days. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with whatever you touch, do, or say this week. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the ever-blessed Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. May light perpetual continue to shine upon their graves. Lord, may angels lead them into paradise. May the saints and martyrs receive them on their arrival and lead them into God's eternal kingdom and everlasting life. May the choirs of heaven receive them and grant them eternal rest. We say this through him who came and died to save our sins, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now, I'd just like to just... Loving God, we remember in your presence all those who have died in war and those who still live with the pain of losing someone they love. We remember people who today live in fear of their lives, and those who fear the knock on the door or the telephone call that heralds bad news. We remember politicians and others who hold positions of power and influence, and whose decisions can lead to other people's life or death. And we commit ourselves not only to pray, but to seek and make peace in our relationships, in our communities, and in our world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So this day, as we're not just remembering those who died, but most important, 44. Mark's Gospel, chapter 12, verses 41 to 44. Very soon I'll be having these readings on the screen. Verse 41 of Mark 12, it reads, as Jesus sat near the temple treasury, he watched the people as they dropped their money. Many rich men dropped in a lot of money. Then a poor widow came along and dropped in two little copper coins worth about a penny. He called his disciples together and said to them, I tell you that this poor widow put more in the offering box than all the others. For the others put in what they had to spare of their riches, but she, the poor lady, put in all she had. She gave all she had to live on. Why even this story? Now, you know, when I go to church, there is something I enjoy most of the time. You know, that they have some grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are those who are watching. Blessed are those who come from the east, from the west, from the north, and from the south. God of glory, you brought the universe into existence and raised up witnesses and prophets to your greatness and love. Grant that by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit and praise and worship, we will continue to serve you through Jesus Christ our Lord. I said, the first commandment is, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. And you shall love your neighbor as yourself. That is the second commandment. I will be celebrating my birthday this year on the 20th of December. Join me in prayer. And while I pray for you, please pray for me as well. Loving God, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. You've been with us since we were in our mother's womb. And now we're out celebrating life. But in all these celebrations, it would not have been possible without your nourishment. Lord, continue to nourish us as you do nourish these leaves, these plants planted by the river of water, by the rivers of water. May we continue to cling on to your river of life. Lord, we give you thanks for all those celebrating their birthdays during this month of December. We give you thanks for all those who celebrated their birthdays last month. We give you thanks for all those who have celebrated their birthdays this year, right here and not in eternity. Lord, in their celebrations, may they know that you are with them. Lord, may they not mourn for the things that they have not achieved throughout the years, but may they have that hope, believing that with you at the hem of things, everyone will have his or her own portion. Lord, this we ask in the name of your Son, who is to come again on Christmas Day, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so they remember all those who are mourning, those who Christmas will not be a joyful time, as they remember family members, friends who celebrated Christmas with them last year or years gone by. Lord, at this time, I remember and I put into your care and comfort the parents, the relatives and friends of the two young Cambridge graduates and the Cambridge students who lost their lives at the terror attack on London Bridge on Friday. Lord, no doubt this Christmas will not be the same for their families. This Christmas will not be the same as Christmas last year. For together they had been planning to celebrate Christmas. O Lord, in your mercy, give comfort to all those who sorrow, and may the faithfully departed, may they rest in perfect peace. Amen. Will guide and protect us. Let us pray. Light in our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercies, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. To this end, may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, be with whatever we touch, do, or say. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the ever-blessed Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us all, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. I wish you all a very, very successful week. Advent is hope. Hope for the best. Hope amidst, because it's light in darkness. That's why we have the candles. If you think you're in darkness now, don't be afraid. Don't give up. Light is on its way. Advent means coming. Light is coming. Next week, we'll talk about light. We'll talk about light. The idea with you right now, but I guess you've invited me. Maybe you have not even invited me, but you have invited the Word of God to dwell with you this Sunday, this second Sunday in Advent. As I always say, this Sunday good word does not come from me or from Diaspora Voices. The Sunday good word, the word itself, comes from God. And peace be to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are those who will come from east and west, from north and south, to feast in the kingdom of God. God of all glory, you brought the universe into existence and raised up witnesses to your greatness and love. We praise and adore you. Grant that by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, we may worship and serve you and praise your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We continue in prayer. We continue in prayer. Lord, by your presence, light up the past that we may learn from it with thankfulness. Light up the present that we may live in it with love. Light up the future that we might prepare to live in it as we hope. So Lord, as we watch and wait, may we be ready to meet others with love. This we ask in the name of your Son, who is to come on Christmas Day, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. So,